Okay, so in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at finding decimal percentages of certain amounts. In a previous video, we actually looked at finding whole number percentages by partitioning our percentage into tens and units, and then using multiples of those to find the percentage that we actually need. So if you want to check that video out first, I'll leave a link for it in the description and also a card in the top corner. So we're going to do something very similar for these questions today. To find our decimal percentages, what we're going to do is split our percentages up into tens, units, and tenths. So for this first question, we've got to find the value of 14.5% of 140. So to begin with, I'm just going to find what 10% would be, because to find 10% of any number, all I have to do is divide that number by 10. So we take our 140, divide it by 10, that would actually give us 14. Once we've found 10%, we can then find 1% by dividing by 10 again. So then we'd have to take our 14 and divide that by 10, which would give us 1.4. So for this particular example, we also need 0.5% as well. So in this scenario, we can actually get straight from our 1% to our 0.5%. So to get from 1% to 0.5%, all I have to do in this case is actually divide by 2. So we're going to do exactly the same on the right-hand side. We've got 1.4. We're going to divide that by 2. That'll give us 0.7. We've now got all the relevant percentages we need. So we're going to use multiples of these percentages to make up our 14.5%. So we're still going to need our 10%. We're going to keep that as it is. So our 10% was equal to 14. So then I need to find what 4% would be. Well, to find 4%, all we're going to do is take our 1%, which was equivalent to 1.4, and then we're going to multiply that by 4. So we do 4 times 4, which gives us 16. So 6 carry the 1. 4 times 1, which is 4, add the 1, which is 5. So that would give us 5.6. We also then need the remaining 0.5%, which we've already figured out. So the 0.5% we know is 0.7. So all we need to do now to find this 14.5% is add these numbers together. So adding all these columns, we'd have 14.0, add 5.6, add 0.7. Well, starting on the right-hand side, we'd have 6 add 7, which is 13. So 3, carry our 1. We'd have 4 add 5, which is 9. Add the 1, which is 10. So 0, carry our 1. And then finally, we'd have 1, add on the 1 we've carried over, would give us a 2. So the answer to this question, 14.5% of 140 would be equal to 20.3. Okay, and for this next question, we've got 21.3% of 320. So to begin with, I'm going to find my 10%. So to do this, all we're going to do is take our 320, divide it by 10, that'd give us 32. We're then going to take this 10% and divide by 10 again, so that'd give us what 1% is. So we'd have to do 32 divided by 10, which gives us 3.2. And now we've got to find the remaining 0.3%. So what we're going to do now is we're actually going to find our 0.1%. So to do that, we take our 1% and we divide by 10 again. So this is going to give me 0.1%. So dividing that 3.2 by 10, that'd give me 0.32. So now I'm going to find multiples of these percentages to make up that 21.3%. So we're going to need 20%, and we can find that by multiplying our 10% by 2. So 32 multiplied by 2 would give us 64. In the units, we need 1%. Well, we've already got our 1%, so we can just write that underneath as 3.2. And then finally, we need a remaining 0.3%. Well, we know what 0.1% is. It's 0.32. So all I need to do now is multiply that by 3. So multiplying through, we get 2 times 3, which is 6, 3 times 3, which is 9, and 3 times 0, which is 0. So our 0.3% would be equivalent to 0.96. So as before, all we're going to do now is add our columns together.
So adding all these columns on the left, that gets me to my 21.3%. I just need to add the columns now on the right-hand side. So I'm going to use some column addition. So I'm going to put these all to two decimal places to make it line up. And then just add through. So we've got 0, add 0, add 6, which is 6. 0, add 2, add 9, which is 11. So 1, carry over a 1. We've then got 4, add 3, which is 7. Add on 1 is 8. And then 6 all on its own, so 6. So for this particular question, 21.3% of 320 is equal to 68.16. So that's the method we're going to use today. To find these more difficult decimal percentages, we're going to partition these percentages into 10%, 1%, and 0.1%. And then find multiples of these to make the percentage that we need. So hopefully that made sense. We're now going to look at some more examples. Okay, so feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for this first example, we've got find the value of 34.2% of 650. So just like before, what we're going to do first is find what our 10% would be equivalent to. So 10% of 650 would actually be 65. We're then going to find our 1% by dividing by 10 again. So if we divide that 65 by 10, we get 6.5. And then finally, we're going to find our 0.1% by dividing by 10 again. So if we do 6.5 divided by 10 again, we get 0.65. Okay, so we're now going to use multiples of these to find the percentage that we need. So in our tens column, we actually need 30%. So to find 30%, all I'm going to do is take this 65 and I'm going to multiply it by 3. So if I do 5 times 3, that'll give me 15. So carry the 1. 3 times 6 is 18. Add the 1 is 19. So that would be equal to 195. In our units column, we actually need 4% now. So to find 4%, all we're going to do is take our 6.5 and we're then going to multiply that by 4. So 6.5 multiplied by 4. To begin with, I'd do 4 times 5, which is 20. So 0 carry R2. And then 4 times 6, which is 24. Add on R2 gives us 26. So our 4% would be equivalent to 26. And then finally, in our tenths column, we need 0.2%. Well, we know what 0.1% is. That's 0.65. So now all I have to do to find what 0.2% is times that by 2. So times in 3 by 2, we'd have 2 times 5, which is 10. So 0 carry R1. 2 times 6, which is 12, add R1 is 13, so 3 carry R1, and then 2 times 0 is 0, add R1 is 1. So our 0.2% would be equal to 1.3. So now all we need to do is add all our columns together to find our 34.2%. So on the right hand side, I'm going to put it to one decimal place just to line these up. So I'm going to have 0.0 there, 0.0 there. So then starting from the right hand side, we'd have 0 add 0 add 3, which is 3. We'd have 5 add 6, which is 11. Add 1 gives us 12, so 2, carry over our 1. We'd have 9 add 2, which is 11. Add on our 1 is 12, so 2, carry our 1 again. And then we'd have 1 add the 1 we just carried over, gives us 2. So 34.2% of 650 is equal to 222.3. Okay, for this next example, we've got 71.3% of 410. So just like before, we're going to find our 10% first. So to do that, we're going to take this 410, divide it by 10, that gives us 41. We're then going to find our 1% by dividing by 10 again. So 41 divided by 10 would give us 4.1, and then we're going to find our 0.1% by dividing by 10 again. So 4.1 divided by 10 would give us 0.41. So we're now just going to find the multiples of these that we need. So looking back to our percentage, we need 71.3%. So in our tens column, we actually need 70%. So to find this, we're going to take our 10%, which is 41, and we're then going to multiply this by 7. So if I do 7 times 1, that gives me 7, and then 7 times 4 gives me 28. So 70% would be equal to 287. Looking back in our units column, we need 1%, but fortunately we've already figured out what 1% is. So 1% is equivalent to 4.1. So writing that under the correct columns, we'd have 4.1. And then finally, in our tenths column, we actually need 0.3%. So to find the 0.3%, all we would do is take our 0.1% value, which was 0.41. We're then going to multiply that by 3. So we'd have 3 times 1, which is 3. 3 times 4, which is 12. So 2, carry our 1. And then 3 times 0, which is 0. Add the 1 that we've just carried over. That would be equivalent to 1.23. So all we need to do now to find our 71.3% is just add these columns together. So on the right hand side, we're going to put everything to 2 decimal places just so it lines up nicely. So starting from the right, we'd have 0, add 0, add 3 gives us 3. 0, add 1, add 2 gives us 3. 7, add 4 is 11. Add 1 gives us 12, so 2, carry over our 1. We've then got 8, add the 1 we carried, gives us 9. And then 2 on its own, so 2 right at the front. So our final answer to 71.3% of 410 is 292.33. And for this final question, we've got find the value of 46.7% of 8,200. So just like the examples we've done before, the first thing we're going to find is what 10% would be. So to find 10%, all we're going to do is take that 8,200, divide it by 10, that'd give us 820. We're then going to find what 1% would be by dividing by 10 again. So 820 divided by 10 will give us 82. And then we're going to find what 0.1% would be by dividing by a further 10. So 82 divided by 10 gives us 8.2. Okay, so then we're going to find the multiples of these that we actually need. So looking at our percentage of 46.7%, in the tens column, we've got 40%. So to find our 40%, all we do is we take our value for 10%, which was 820, and then we're going to multiply this by 4. So we'd have 0 times 4, which is 0, 4 times 2, which is 8, and then 4 times 8, which is 32. So our answer here would be 3,280. In our units column, we then need 6%. So to find this, we're going to take our value of 1%, which we know is 82, and then we're going to simply multiply this by 6. So we'd have 6 times 2, which is 12, so 2 carry our 1, and then 6 times 8, which is 48, add on the 1, gives us 49. So 6% would be equivalent to 492. And in our tenths column, we actually need 0.7%. So to find the value of this, all we're going to do is take our value of 0.1%, which we figured out to be 8.2. And we're then just going to multiply this by 7. So multiplying through, we get 7 times 2, which is 14. So 4 carry our 1. We then do 7 times 8, which is 56. Add on the 1 we've carried over, gives us 57. So 0.7% would be equivalent to 57.4. So we found all the components we need. All we need to do now is add our columns together to give us our 46.7%. So lining these columns up, I'm going to put all of these to one decimal place just so it lines up nicely. So then starting from the right hand side, we've got 0, add 0, add 4, which gives us 4. We've then got 0, add 2, add 7 is 9. We've then got 8, add 9, which is 17. Add on the 5 is 22, so 2, carry over our 2. We've then got 2, add 4, which is 6. Add on our 2 is 8. And then 3 on its own, which goes right at the front. So the final answer to 46.7% of 8,200 is 3,829.4. So well done if you followed along with those examples. And that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments. And I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.